Hello, I'm James Carmichael Renick, Senior Advisor to Dr. Carolyn Myers at Jackson State University. And I'm here today to talk to two art aficionados, one who has been collecting, a person who has been collecting art for a long period of time, and two, a young lady who runs the latest initiative on the Jackson State campus. I'm here today with Dr. Walter O. Evans, a major collector of African American art, and Kimberly Jacobs, the director of the newly opened Gallery One art space on John R. Lynch Street. Hello.
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 How are you both today?
Great.
Doing well.
We're here to talk about art and the role art has in someone's life. And I want to start with you, Dr. Evans. You've been collecting art for a long period of time. And can you tell us how you started collecting art? Was it a natural thing, or?
It was fairly natural for me because I got interested in art after high school. I had never been in an art museum before, and a lady asked me to go on a date to the Philadelphia Museum of Art. I was in the Navy, and as soon as I was transferred from San Diego to Philadelphia, I met this young lady. And to learn a little bit more about what I was to see in that art museum, I went to the library and I started reading about Renoir, Degas, Monet, and many of the European and the American artists. So when we went on the date, I started telling her about these different artists that we saw, and she was quite impressed. Okay. So
your motivation wasn't art altogether initially.
It was not art, but it was to impress this date. It wouldn't have been, it was many years from that time that I started collecting, to answer your question. Okay. But by that time, I had read about some of the African-American artists, and I was living in Detroit. I had earned my first dollar practicing as a surgeon. And at the same time, the Detroit Institute of Arts had commissioned the John Brown series prints. So that was my first purchase, and it was quite natural for me because I had already been reading about this artist and many others.
So you have a connection to Jackson State.
I do. My connection to Jackson State actually is through Dr. Margaret Walker Alexander. I actually picked up a phone book and saw that she was listed in the Jackson phone book, and I cold called her, and I wanted to meet her because I had read all of her books. And she said, of course, come on down. I actually arrived in Jackson about 5 in the morning, and my wife and daughters who were with me said, please don't go by her house at 5 in the morning. And I went at 6. And she was so warm and friendly. And it was at that time that I invited her to come up to Detroit to speak. And that was in the mid to late 80s. She came up to, she had been a professor here at Jackson State. And she came up to speak in Detroit. She would come up many more times. But we arranged to have an exhibition of Ollie Harrington's work. Ollie Harrington is a quite eminent African-American cartoonist who had gone out of the country, and I brought him back to this country after he had been an expatriate for many, many years. Dr. Alexander had never met him in person, although she knew him through Richard Wright. So we had the exhibition here at Jackson State of Ollie Harrington's work.
So you've been coming to Jackson State on and off for?
Yes, but mainly to see Margaret Walker and for programs either related to her or to that exhibition we had of Ollie Harrington's work.
That's fantastic. Well, Kimberly, you've been directing a major initiative on John R. Lynch Street. Can you talk a little bit about Gallery One?
Absolutely. Gallery One is a fine art gallery dedicated to celebrating African-American artists and our culture, and it's there for students to come in and learn. It functions both as a commercial gallery and a museum, and it's about celebrating our culture and coming in and taking a piece of it with you, and for students to embrace and learn more about the arts. And it's a great initiative, and it opens a lot of doors and opportunities for education at Jackson State. So
there seems to be a renaissance of the arts at Jackson State.
It is.
And you're right in the middle of it.
It is. I am. And it's definitely exciting. You know, the students, I feel like I am someone that they can relate to, because they come in and they expect, a stuffy older gallery director, but they get me instead. No offense to anybody, but they get me. And, you know, and I'm able to interpret and kind of relay the message that that African American art gives, and give that to them, and take and have them, you know, embrace that history.
Well, you're a graduate.
I am a graduate of Jackson State. I graduated in 2009.
That's
so
fantastic.
Alumni and fine art major.
So you've actually been able to practice your craft, and you're an artist as well.
I am an artist as well. Yes.
Isn't that fantastic?
I haven't done much since undergrad, but I definitely take a lot of inspiration from what I see daily in the students and this learning from gentlemen like yourself.
You know what's fascinating, mm-hmm. is here we have Kimberly. You're on the front end of all of the good things that you've done and you're going to do, and Dr. Evans, you for such a long time have been collecting these major pieces of art, and you know, one question I had was, how do you find these major pieces of artwork? I mean, I've gone into lots of homes and I don't see them there. And I mean, how do you? What process do you use?
Well, in the beginning, I not long after I acquired this John Brown series through the Detroit Institute of Arts, I was in New York, and a colleague of mine, Dr. Benny Prim, had a party for Romare Bearden's wife to support her dance studio. So he had given, Romare Bearden had given his wife these works of art, his own works, as a fundraiser. Mm-hmm. So I acquired that. So in the beginning, I bought from the artists, and I got to know the artists. I had one of these fundraisers at my home in Detroit. So I went around to the artists at first, Huey Lee Smith, Jacob Lawrence, and I sought them out, brought them to Detroit when those who would come. But later, after galleries and there weren't many carrying African-American art in these days, and auctions, I went to auctions, Sotheby's and Christie's, and again, there were only a few artists that these auction houses would carry in those early days. But that's how I got started. And later, as African-American art became more popular and the museums started collecting, the galleries and really auction houses also, they started calling me.
Hmm. But you know what I find interesting is that you've collected the masters, mm-hmm. For such a significant period of time. And Kimberly, your folks seem to be focused on the up and coming, mm-hmm. artists. Can you talk about some of the artists that you have in the studio there?
Absolutely. One of my most notable artists that we represent is Ted Ellis, and his work, again, more of the contemporary African American art, looking at it from what was done by the old masters and what's kind of now, is that the story is evolving to sort of represent what's going on in our culture, and looking back and interpreting it in a new way. And that's something that is interesting, and that I like for the students to really understand, again, mm-hmm. that's important to understand our history by looking at it visually through art. So
what's so interesting to me is, mm-hmm. how the everything seems to be coming together at a wonderful time. Gallery One is opened, and it's a beautiful space. And if you haven't been there, if people haven't been there, you need to go to Gallery One on John R. Lynch Street. It's just beautiful. And we have a new university president who will be inaugurated in March, actually March 28th through the 30th. And Dr. Evans has graciously agreed to show his collection during the inaugural reception and actually beyond at the Mississippi Museum of Art. And so that is really, we're just delighted to have those works of art.
That's great.
You know, one thing that you haven't been a selfish collector, because there are a lot of people who collect art and you never mm-hmm. see it unless you visit their houses. Mm-hmm. But you, for a long period of time, can you talk about how your art travels?
Well, yes, we organize a traveling exhibition of about 70 works, and actually they traveled to almost 50 museums over a period of 16 years. And we would change the exhibition and customize it for the museum or for the city. The reason I did this was because going into that museum was a game changer for me. It changed my entire life. It not only got me interested in art, but literature as well, because I started reading about the artists, and many of the authors also wrote books that were interesting to me. So I dove into the libraries as well as the museums. So it's for that. Now, usually, if a person hasn't gone to a museum by the time that I did at the age of 19, it's usually too late to get them interested in museum. But fortunately, I had a very compelling reason to go. So that's why I like to share my art, because I think if it changed my life as much as it did. Now, let me say this. I probably would have been a surgeon anyway, but I would not have had the rich life that I've led if I had known these artists and known their work.
Mm. That is just incredible. That is, well, Kimberly, can you talk about, because I know you had a grand opening not too long ago, and
August 30th was our official opening date, and it's been wonderful. The community has embraced the space, the students as well. Mm-hmm. It's been phenomenal. And again, like you said, you know how it's changed your life, and at that age, you know, college students, they're at that age, and it was also a pivotal moment for me in my life as well. And Gallery One, that's our goal. To give that to the students right there on the campus, and that's why it's so important for them to learn and come and support.